I've come outside to take a stroll with Julius Baer's Chief Investment Officer, Yves Bonzon. He told me about the lessons he's learned during the pandemic, how he thinks crypto will impact the financial industry as a whole, and he revealed his favourite pandemic read. Come take a walk with us. Yves, good to see you.
Good to see you, Anna.
Outside the office for once. I suppose everybody is doing this a bit more often, getting to kind of leave the office, leave the house, get out and about. But looking back on the last 18 months and what's just happened, what for you were the biggest financial stories to come out of the pandemic?
I think the biggest story of the pandemic is the acceleration. Alex, acceleration of the digitalization of the economy, an acceleration of the transition towards a new approach to macroeconomic policy making, including the use of fiscal deficits.
What about cryptocurrency? Because that might be, you know, something that we talk about all the time, but when we really think about the headlines, cryptocurrency is right in the middle of the pandemic. We're hitting the headlines, they're all-time highs. Yeah. What does it mean for the financial industry?
I think the impact is very, very difficult to grasp for the following reasons. A, there is the technological issue. We are in the early innings of encryption, this ability to digitize trust. We know it can have dramatic disruptive consequences for the legacy financial system, the centralized ones. But all of this is a function not just of technology, but what governments will let happen, how regulations will evolve. And this combination of the technological uncertainty, the regulatory unknown, makes the future of crypto extremely hard to predict.
One of the things, and I guess this is kind of related to crypto or Bitcoin, is in the environment. I mean, you know, Bitcoin prices, you know, kind of dropped as soon as Elon Musk said he wasn't interested anymore because of the environmental impact. But really, for me, when we think back to the pandemic, everybody has been talking about sustainability and the environment. How important is ESG for investors going forward?
I think ESG is a topic of the utmost importance. It's a topic whose importance is growing very rapidly. The interesting part is we've come to the point of realization. We should not just talk about it, but we should be very concrete. We've coined it in the sustainability board at Julius Baer. We want to do good, we don't want to feel good. And I think ESG, unfortunately, has been in some instances leveraged for storytelling purpose, commercial purpose, not necessarily with substantiated claims.
So what should investors look for then?
They should look for how their advisor approach ESG, what matters to them. Mindful that finance cannot solve all of the problems of the world, but at least that we are really pushing hard in the right direction, whether it's climate, whether it's social responsibility, inequalities. There are so many multiple topics on which you can engage. It's fascinating. But you want to do it with the true conviction that you are really pushing in the right direction.
All right, I want to change gears slightly and maybe put you on the spot a little bit, because this is fair to say that the pandemic, you know, it's not your first crisis. When we dealt with the 2008 crisis, you actually pulled out of equities.
Yes.
Just before. But you can't really have been as well prepared for this crisis, for the pandemic, were you?
Totally. I mean, The 2008
totally
crisis,
totally not.
Totally not prepared.
Okay, okay.
No, I mean, the 2008 crisis was a very endogenous mechanism. So it's a mechanism that has drivers that you can track, monitor, understand, and you do also understand more or less the kind of policy response that needs to be implemented to stem the contagion effect in the system. The pandemic is of a very different nature. The system into the pandemic was very stable, very solid. And the world economy and financial markets were hit by something that some have compared, and I think rightly so, to a kind of natural catastrophe. You know? So by definition, you cannot predict reliably an earthquake. You know they can happen. It's really the strategic structure of your portfolio that protects you against these unpredictable events. But then the question is, how do you respond when they happen? And what we've observed last year, and that's why we although we did not predict the pandemic, we navigated very well and to a certain extent took advantage of opportunities in market, is because we understood what was needed from governments to stabilize the economy and shield the private sector from permanent losses, including the negative wealth effects of falling asset prices. And the policy response has been amazingly rapid. To give you an idea, in the 1930s, during the Great Depression in America, it took a few years to the governments to really come up with the correct policy response, including debasing the dollar against gold. In 2008, more or less a year and a half until we got from Washington and the Fed the right policy response. Last year, it took 3 weeks. So it's a tremendous progress in this respect.
Okay, so my friends have been telling me that the pandemic was a time for us to catch up on our reading. Eve, perhaps I can ask you, what were your big reads of the pandemic? What book recommendations do you have for us?
Well,
today?
I've read the Kai-Fu Lee, Artificial Intelligence and Superpowers, essentially discussing the difference between Silicon Valley and China. And that's interesting in the wake of the regulatory crackdown on digital business models and data collection that has happened in China over the recent month, because as compared with the point at which the book was written, it's a potential significant game changer for China and Chinese assets. I'm currently reading Noise from Kahneman because I think Slow Brain, Fast Brain is a must read for everyone investing money, understanding how we react to news. And there, the discussion is about distinguishing the noise from what really matters and understanding that our decision can be polluted by noise.
Well, we do often talk about shutting out the noise, don't we, in finance. Eve, always a pleasure to talk to you. Thank
Likewise,
you very much
Anna.
Indeed.
Thank
and
you.
What a great view we have for us today as well. It's really great that we actually got some good weather finally.
Absolutely. Thank you, Anna.